Good day, everyone. Welcome to Prayer Watch. Thank you for joining us again. Let us begin with a prayer. Most gracious and loving God, our Father in heaven, thank you for calling us together to this place, to this hour, to receive from you, O God, your words of truth and love. Thank you for all the blessings that you continue to shower upon us, especially the blessing of your presence, your power, and your word. Be with us today as we look into a very important message that you have for us. We pray that you will guide us by your Holy Spirit and touch us in our minds, in our hearts, and in our will. This is our prayer in Jesus' name. Amen.
Matthew 26. While Jesus was in Bethany in the home of Simon the leper, a woman came to him with an alabaster jar of very expensive perfume, which she poured on his head as he was reclining at the table. When the disciples saw this, they were indignant. "Why this waste?" they asked. "This perfume could have been sold at a high price, and the money given to the poor." Aware of this, Jesus said to them, "Why are you bothering this woman? She has done a beautiful thing to me. The poor you will always have with you, but you will not always have me. When she poured this perfume on my body, she did it to prepare me for burial. Truly I tell you, wherever this gospel is preached throughout the world, what she has done will also be told in memory of her." Then one of the 12, the one called Judas Iscariot, went to the chief priests and asked, "What are you willing to give me if I deliver him over to you?" So they counted out for him 30 pieces of silver. From then on, Judas watched for an opportunity to hand him over.
Praise God for his wonderful words of life and love and truth. Have you ever experienced loving someone so much that you gave of yourself fully and even all that you have for the sake of that person? Today, as we celebrate and observe Holy Wednesday, when Christians commemorate the last week of Jesus' earthly life and ministry, we read something of that kind of extravagant love in Matthew chapter 26. But likewise, immediately after this event, we read of a stark contrast narrated. That is the betrayal of love for the amount of 30 pieces of silver. Two opposite responses to the love of Jesus Christ, who, as expressed by the Gospel of John in chapter 13, verse 3, says, "Having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end." Why did the woman pour out expensive perfume on Jesus? There is a similar account we read in the Gospel of Luke, chapter 7, where the text says that a woman who lived a sinful life came to Jesus at a house where he was invited, and as she stood behind Jesus, she began to weep, and tears fell at his feet, which she then kissed and poured perfume on. What was this sinful woman thinking of as she sought to meet Jesus? Upon seeing him, so that she broke into tears. The narrative is silent, but it was Jesus who spoke up, saying, She has poured perfume on my feet. I tell you, her many sins have been forgiven, as her great love has shown. Afterwards, turning to the woman, Jesus said, "Your sins are forgiven. Your faith has saved you. Go in peace." That woman believed in Jesus' love and power to forgive. That is why she was overwhelmed to the point of deep repentance. She was overwhelmed with a thankful, grateful heart of love. Perhaps the woman in Bethany also felt the same way. Could she have been one of the followers of Jesus who believed and received the great love and mercy of the Savior? The disciples couldn't believe that anyone who was practical enough to see the many needy around them would waste, quote-unquote, waste such treasure on a mere ceremonial act of anointing the head of Jesus. Again, the woman here in this story is silent. And then again, it is Jesus who speaks up in her defense. He said, "Why are you bothering this woman? She has done a beautiful thing to me. When she poured this perfume on my body, she did it to prepare me for burial." True enough, 2 days later, Jesus was hung on the cross, and we know that he laid down his life for the forgiveness of that woman's sins, and not only for her sins, but for ours as well. In contrast, Judas Iscariot, one of the 12 disciples, chosen disciples, left Jesus to go to the chief priests. He did not have anything to give to Jesus, unlike the woman. Instead, he was negotiating with the chief priests, with Jesus' enemies, on how much he would get if he led them to where they could arrest Jesus. "What are you willing to give me if I deliver him over to you?" That was his question. And for 30 pieces of silver, the deal was settled. This, both the woman and Judas Iscariot, received and experienced Jesus' love. Forgiveness and mercy were offered to them both, but their responses were poles apart. Holy Week is here to remind us that God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. Perhaps it is but right that we realize how great a love God has for us because of our great transgressions and sins against the Holy God. And yet, he was willing and able to forgive through Jesus Christ. What is your response to such a great love? Far be it from us that our thoughts and actions show that we consider our time with and for God a waste of time that could have been given to our work, our leisure, or to persons or hobbies that we love more. Let it not be said that our talents and efforts on endeavors that are needed for the building of his kingdom, like evangelism, missions, serving the church, can be put to better use elsewhere. Let it not be said that in proportion to our treasures, what we give for the work of the Lord is but a meager or token left over, because there are more important things to spend on. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, instead, let it be said of us that, Lord, let it be that we could truly and honestly say, Lord, I give this to you wholeheartedly and with much sacrifice, because this is for you, O God. This is for you. I do not expect anything else in return, because you have already given me much more than I could ever deserve, much more than I could ever imagine when you saved me from my sins. But this gift that I have for you, Lord, this work that I do, it is for you. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, God wants us to love much, because He first and generously loved us. May our love for God be a fragrant aroma to Jesus Christ, the kind of love that He will come to our defense for, and which He will be proud of, a faithful and true love that we will not exchange for anything else in the world. And so let me go back to my first question at the beginning. Have you experienced loving someone so much that you gave of yourself and all that you have for the sake of that person? I believe that every Christian, every true lover of Christ would say, yes, I have experienced loving that person, one person, so much that I gave of myself and everything that I have for that person. And I believe that person must be no less than our Lord Jesus Christ.
Village woman, driven by love for her Lord, recklessly poured out valuable lessons, disregarding was broken and spilled out. A fragrance filled all the room, like a prisoner released from his shackles, like a spirit set free from the tomb. Just for love of me. precious treasure. His loved, His own perfect Son, sent here to show us the love of the Father. Yes, just for love it was done. And though you were perfect and holy, you gave up yourself willingly. You spared no expense for my pardon. You were spilled out and wasted.
Shall we pray? Loving God, generous, merciful, kind, thank you so much, O Lord, for your great love for us in Christ Jesus. Thank you that you are indeed a Father, a perfect Father in heaven, who loves us so unconditionally because Jesus Christ has paid the price, and because we have put our utmost faith in Him. Dearest Lord, indeed, there is nothing that we can do to repay such a life-giving, eternal love that you have given us. But thank you for that love that empowers us to love you in return, and to love our neighbors also with a sacrificial kind of love. Dearest Lord, may we learn more and more to love you as we ought, because you first loved us so generously. Lord God, that is our prayer, because you said that when we love you with all our heart, with all our soul, our mind and our strength, and our neighbor, Lord, we have fulfilled the first and greatest commandment. May our lives truly glorify you, O Lord, and exalt your glorious name. This is our prayer in Jesus' name. Amen. Goodbye for now, everyone, and I pray and I wish you a very blessed and meaningful Holy Week observance. God bless you.